Hello students, there is a quotation, I hear and I forget, I see and I remember, I do and I understand. This emphasizes the importance of an activity. Today we shall perform an activity to verify that a median of a triangle divides it into two triangles of equal area. Material required: a squared paper, colored pens, a ruler and a pencil. Take a squared paper. Draw any triangle on it. Mark and label three non-collinear points. Say A, B and C. Join AB join BC and join CA. Our triangle is ready. Now we find the midpoint of the side BC. To find midpoint of the side BC, we first measure its length. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. The length of BC is 10 units. The midpoint is at equal distance from B and C. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let the midpoint be D. We observe that the length of BD and the length of DC are equal. Both of them are 5 units. Now we join the vertex A to the midpoint of the opposite side D. The line segment AD, you all know, is the median. Children, what do you observe? The median of a triangle divides it into two triangles, namely ABD and ADC. Next, we find the areas of these two triangles by counting the squares. The replica of the triangle we have just made is ready with us. We observe that some of the squares inside these triangles are fully filled, like shown in the chart here. The area of these squares is taken as one square unit. Some of the squares like these are more than half filled. These are the more than half filled squares. The area of each of these squares is taken as one square unit, as they are counted as one square. Some of the squares like these are exactly half filled. The area of each of these squares is taken as half square unit. The remaining squares are less than half filled, which we ignore. Now let us find the area of triangle ABD. Let us count the number of fully filled squares. Fully filled squares are F, and these are denoted by a red dot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So fully filled squares are 9 in number. Next, we count the more than half filled squares. We denote them by a blue dot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. These are 8 in number. Now we count the number of squares which are exactly half filled, and we show them by a green dot. There is one such square. The estimate of the area of triangle ABD is fully filled squares F, more than half filled squares M, plus half of the half filled squares. So substituting these values, we get 9 plus 8 plus half of 1. This comes out to be 17 and a half square units. Similarly, we will find area of triangle ADC. We first count the fully filled squares and represent them by a dot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, the number of fully filled squares are 10 in number. Next, we find the squares which are more than half filled and we represent them by a blue dot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These are 7 in number. Similarly, we will find the squares which are exactly half filled. There is one such square. So, value of H is 1. The remaining squares are less than half filled, which we ignore. Now, substituting these values in the formula to find the estimate of the triangle ADC, we get 10 plus 7 plus half of 1. This comes out to be 17 and a half square units. The estimate of the area of triangle ABD is equal to 17 and a half square units. And the estimate of the area of triangle ADC also comes out to be 17 and a half square units. What do you observe? We have verified that a median of a triangle divides it into two triangles of equal area. Now, children, I have a query for you. Can you calculate the area of these two triangles by a mathematical formula? Think about it. Thank you.